Hey everybody, good evening. My name is Vishwadeep and I welcome you all on Unacademy Computer Science channel for Unlimited Learning. We are continuing our operating system series in which today's discussion's topic is TLB and how we can measure the performance and improve the performance of paging. So let's start the session and let's have the learning started. Before we begin the session, let me introduce myself for those members who don't know about me. My name is Vishwadeep Ghoti and I'm working as a channel leader on this channel. You can see my profile here. If you guys are learning, this channel is providing you a lot of content. For self-learning people who are learning for self for gate preparation, then tomorrow I am going to have a big announcement for all of you, 3:30 p.m. So if you are listening this particular lecture, please be aware of the upcoming session and be available for that session, just because I am gonna bring you a really, really big thing. If you want to learn in more interactive manner on from us, for your computer science problems, then you can create your account on Unacademy platform. Go to unacademy.com or download Unacademy Learner app and follow my profile so that you can access my all the free classes which are under the section special classes. Use this code to unlock special classes. You can unlock the classes and you can unlock free content which includes practice questions, quizzes, test series also using this code. If you are preparing for GATE and if you are feeling like your preparation is not on the track, but why? Just because you are not able to have a quality content with you, or if you are not able to have the good structured schedule with you, proper management is not there with the content or with the doubt solving or multiple other problems you are facing, then we can provide the solution on Unacademy's platform. That is Unacademy Plus subscription. This Plus subscription will provide you live classes which are very, very interactive in nature, to learn daily practice problems, to understand how to solve the question using the given topic, weekly test, quizzes, doubt solving, Hindi English batches, rank improvement batches, and you will have the courses in more structured, more organized and more systematic manner, so that your learning will always be as efficient as you wanted always. This Plus subscription you can purchase for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, 18 months and 24 months based on your subscription duration, your target exam duration. You can take the subscription of any month. Use this code VDEEP10 to get 10% discount plus my personal guidance and my team's support for your subscription. These are the prices after the discount. There is another type of subscription we have that includes all the benefit of Unacademy Plus and having a personal coach benefit. Personal coach, an expert who will be provided to you for one-to-one guidance, preparation strategy, customized study plan. Your performance will be tracked by an expert. You will get personalized doubt solving. You will get personalized test analysis, study booster session, extra study material, and special notes and sets, practice sets also you will get in this iconic subscription. This iconic subscription is available for 12 months and 24 months only. You use this code VDEEP10, you get 10% discount plus my personal guidance plus my team support. This particular code, if you use, then you will get my personal mentorship in entire your duration of preparation. We wanted and we actually tried to hike the prices, but we extended that price hike. So the price hike gonna be very, very soon. So take the subscription in less prices and enjoy your best quality learning along with the top educators of country. See, this top educators of country will teach you their courses on Unacademy platform. A new batch also started on 7th of July. So you can follow that particular batch and you can follow the top educators and their content on Unacademy's platform. We will start the session now, but before we will start the session, what exactly I always ask you, you need to give me the answer. What is the answer? Are you ready, my dear friend? If you are ready, then we will start the session for the today's topic discussion. So we were discussing paging. Fine. In paging, if suppose CPU generates an address, which address CPU generates? Can you give me the answer? Logical or physical? Logical. Logical address is actually main memory address? No, it's a process address. So can you access directly the main memory content using that address? No. What to do in that case? You need to first have a translation. For what? Logical to physical. After that, you get main memory address where your actual required content is present. इतना सारा स्टोरी का क्या समरी? समरी इज व्हेन सीपीयू जनरेट्स एन एड्रेस टू एक्सेस द कंटेंट टू स्टेप्स यू विल रिक्वायर. फर्स्ट स्टेप यू जस्ट ट्रांसलेट द लॉजिकल एड्रेस टू फिजिकल एड्रेस एंड सेकेंड स्टेप यू एक्सेस द कंटेंट रिक्वायर्ड कंटेंट फ्रॉम मेन मेमोरी. But how do you translate the logical address to physical address? Can you tell me? How do you translate the logical to physical address? Logical to physical address is converted using the page table. And where the page table is stored? Where the page table is stored? Page table ko kahan rakhoge? In the main memory. Yes. So first you access the page table. Yes. How much time required to access the page table? How much time? So I am writing here time to access some content, which is like effective memory access time. How much? Effective memory access time for one request is equal to one time translation time, means that particular translation time requires page table access time so that we can get the frame number and after that content access time. From main memory. Of course, content is in main memory only. Right? Right? Now, in general, by default, what happens? By default, we know that the page table is stored in the main memory. पता ना तुमको पता ना नहीं मालूम मालूम ना तुमको नहीं मालूम मालूम कि नहीं मालूम. Yes. Okay. So, what exactly happens? By default, page table is in main memory. I am writing it. By default, we know that page table is stored in main memory. In that case, above formula will be more specific to page table access time means main memory access time plus content access time from main memory means main memory access time. It becomes two times of main memory access time. Kya bolte ho? Where TMM is main memory access time. TMM is मेन मेमोरी एक्सेस टाइम. कितना गंदा हैंड राइटिंग है रे बाबा. अच्छे से लिखो इसको, बच्चों को समझ में नहीं आएगा. ओके फाइन. सो TMM इज मेन मेमोरी एक्सेस टाइम एंड व्हाई टू टाइम्स? वन पेज टेबल एक्सेस टाइम, वन कंटेंट एक्सेस टाइम. इज इट सिंपल? ओके इजी. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट? नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट? Sometimes the page table is very small. 5 entries, 10 entries, 15 entries, very, very small. Bahut chota page table. Sometimes when page table is very small, CPU can keep entire page table in general purpose registers. In general purpose register, very special case. Very, very special case it is. What I am saying, special case. What is a special case? If page table is very small and I should say is kept in, is stored in registers. Which register? Attendance register? Which register? CPU register. So this one effective memory access time will be equal to one register access time plus main memory access time. As compared to main memory access time, register access time is almost negligible. Very, very small. So very negligible plus main memory access time. Page table access time zero, just because it is very, very small value plus content access time from main memory means TMM. Hence, we will have only TMM one time. That's it. Why? Just because register access time is negligible. Register access time is very small. Fine. Understood? Is it understandable or not? ये समझ में आया कि नहीं आया तुमको? समझ में आया तो yes बोलो, नहीं आया तो नहीं बोलो. At least बोलो तो सही. Okay? And if you haven't liked the session, please session को like कर दो. तो ये होगा दो आपके पास अलग अलग फॉर्मूलाज हैं. इफेक्टिव मेमोरी एक्सेस टाइम आई एम राइटिंग एस टी इफेक्टिव लाइक दिस. ओके, एंड दिस विल बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच मेन मेमोरी एक्सेस टाइम व्हेन ओनली पेज टेबल इज वेरी स्मॉल एंड स्टोर्ड इन द रजिस्टर, टू टाइम्स ऑफ मेन मेमोरी व्हेन पेज टेबल इज स्टोर्ड इन द मेन मेमोरी. इफ नथिंग इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, टेक दिस 2 इनटू टीएमएम. इफ गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन दैट पेज टेबल इज स्मॉल एंड स्टोर इन द रजिस्टर, टेक दिस. ओके, होप यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस. ओके, गुड 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 गुड. नाउ फर्दर we will have to improve the performance. Why? See, this is very special case, and of course not always possible that the page table is very small and can be stored in the registers. No. So every single main memory access request of CPU will take twice of main memory access time, which is of course not good. Achhi baat nahi hai. Do do bar main memory access karne jana is not at all good. So if not at all good, then what happens in that case? We will have to try to improve the performance, and to improve the performance, we will try to use a TLB. TLB is used to improve the performance of paging. सर ये टीएलबी क्या होता है? नाउ लिसन, वेरी सिंपल, वेरी वेरी सिंपल, वेरी वेरी सिंपल. इफ यू यूज द मोबाइल फोन, यू टेल मी how many number of contact details you have saved in your mobile phone. Hundreds of contacts, 200, 300, 500, some thousands of contacts you have already in your phone saved. But among those, how many of those contacts you require very frequently for calling? Some 10, 15 maximum. Yes, and what do you do with those? You keep those in frequently called numbers, like your parents' number or your siblings' number, your best friend's number. You keep them as starred or favorite numbers. You do that? Yes, even I have done the same thing. I have kept my parents' number directly on home screen. I just tap one button and then, yes, a call goes to them. It happens with everybody. Yes. So what exactly the point here is, among all the context which you have in your mobile phone, you don't require every time, every day, all the contacts, right? But you require few of them very frequently. That's why you keep them accessible, directly accessible as soon as you want. So in all the mobile phones, you have fast dialing or some kind of starred or favorite kind of contacts which you can keep, so that frequently accessed contact details you can access in less time. Exactly same kind of concept is this TLB. Yes, what exactly the TLB is? I will explain you the definition, etc., etc. But TLB is exactly on this concept. When CPU generates logical address, we need page table entry. Why? So that we can get physical address. Yes, we have page table stored in the main memory. Great. Operating system kept the page table in main memory. Yes. But in page table, we have entries of all the pages of process. Yes. All the pages of process, CPU does not require very, very frequently always. No, CPU requires few pages very frequently of a process. So what we do, we take those entries of page table which are very, very frequent, which are very, very frequent, and we keep those entries in a small memory called as TLB. The full form of TLB is translation, look aside, buffer. So this particular buffer, a small memory we are using so that we can keep the translation. Translation means logical to physical address translation. So CPU generates logical address. Through that logical address, for that page number, frame number is which one, that we check into the page table. Yes, so frequently accessed page table entries we will keep in this TLB, so that most of the time CPU can get the physical address translation from TLB only, and the access time of TLB is very, very small. TLB का एक्सेस टाइम जो होता है मेन मेमोरी के कंपैरिजन में बहुत बहुत छोटा होता है. सो एग्जैक्टली हाउ वी आर एबल टू इंप्रूव द परफॉर्मेंस वेन एवर द एंट्री विच वी आर लुकिंग फॉर इज प्रेजेंट इन दिस TLB, देन एट दैट टाइम सीपीयू विल हैव टू एक्सेस मेन मेमोरी ओनली वन टाइम. विच वन? टू गेट द डेटा. TLB कैन गिव यू only the translation but cannot give you the data. And when TLB is not having the required entry, then CPU will have to go to page table for main memory access only. Means there are two cases. If you have the translation or frame number inside the TLB only, you will require one TLB access. Yes, for getting the what? Physical address. And from there CPU will go to main memory to get the data. CPU needed the data. Yes, TLB is providing only the physical address, not the data. Right. Second case is when CPU is getting a logical address. For that logical address, entry is not present in TLB, the frame number not present in TLB for that page number, then CPU will have to go to main memory for page table ones and for data ones. So two times main memory accessed anyway, that will be accessed when the entry is not present in TLB. Right? Understood. So what is this TLB? TLB is a translation look aside buffer, is a memory hardware. It's a hardware. Yes, separate chip, small chip will be used. It is used to reduce the time taken to access a memory location. How? It stores few frequently accessed page table entries so that CPU can get physical address without W/O is without accessing main memory in less time. Without accessing the main memory in less time. Understood? Yes. So it's a separate hardware, different hardware chip you are using. So many students say, sir, TLB is just a buffer within the main memory system. No, dear. If you will anyway have a buffer in the main memory system only, then required access time of TLB will be equal to main memory only. Then what will be the change of using the TLB? अगर TLB को भी मेन मेमोरी का ही पार्ट बना दोगे तो फिर मेन मेमोरी का एक्सेस टाइम तो यहां भी लग ही रहा था, आप उतना ही टाइम लोगे. TLB अलग से हार्डवेयर लगता है. देयर इज अनदर सेपरेट हार्डवेयर, अ चिप. दैट पर्टिकुलर मेमोरी चिप इज वेरी वेरी स्मॉल एंड वेरी वेरी फास्ट. दैट इज वाई इट प्रोवाइड्स यू द परफॉर्मेंस इंप्रूवमेंट. अब बात करेंगे कि TLB के थ्रू एक्सेस कैसे होता है डेटा. दिस आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन यू. लुक एट दिस. सीपीयू जनरेट्स लॉजिकल एड्रेस. लॉजिकल एड्रेस हैज पेज नंबर एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट, राइट, ऑफसेट. फाइन. नाउ दिस पेज नंबर वी विल सर्च इनटू टीएलबी. वी विल सर्च इनटू टीएलबी इफ इट इज अ टीएलबी हिट. इफ इट्स अ टीएलबी हिट, then we will get the frame number. Yes, we will get the frame number. We will take this T displacement, we will add it or append the displacement in frame number. We can get the physical address. Yes, we will go to the physical memory and access it to get the data. Physical memory means main memory. But if we have a TLB miss, what happens? We will have to access page table. Yes, from main memory. Yes, from main memory. That will give me frame number. Yes, add that particular frame number in displacement and go to the physical memory or main memory to get the content. Understood? Now if you use the TLB, then what will be the effective memory access time? For that you need to understand two terms. You need to understand two terms. One is TLB hit and another is TLB miss. Can somebody explain me what is TLB hit and TLB miss?
क्या कोई मुझे बता सकता है कि TLB hit और TLB miss क्या होता है?
जल्दी से बताओ, what is the TLB hit and TLB miss? TLB hit is when CPU generated a logical address and that particular logical address has its translation within TLB, right? Page table, or I should say required page table entry is present in TLB. Required page table entry is present in TLB. What is the miss? Required page table entry is not present in TLB. That is TLB miss. So when there is a hit, what happens? When there is a hit, what happens? Effective memory access time will be how much? Look at this. When there is a hit, let's say hit ratio is H. Hit ratio means what is the fraction of or percentage of memory references which are getting hit in TLB. That is TLB hit. So when there is a hit in TLB, at that time one TLB access time is required. Yes, to get the translation done. After that a main memory access time required to get the content. So this is for translation. Translation means logical to physical address, and this is for content. Plus, when there is a miss, if 10% hit, 90% miss, if 80% hit, 20% miss. So 1 minus H is the miss. When there is a miss, first of all, we will require a TLB access time to just confirm that it's a miss. After that, when we understood that it's a miss, we will have to access main memory two times. Why? One time for translation, one time for content. So two times you will have to access the main memory. When there is a TLB miss, this to ensure it's a miss, two times for what and what, one time for translation and one time for content. Now tell me, everything is clear? If yes, then look at this. We do have a question. Now you will have a simple question for me. Sir, is it really possible that using the TLB can actually improve the performance of paging? Yes. How? Let's see. Let's say main memory access time is 300 nanosecond, TLB access time is 20 nanosecond, hit ratio is 80% of TLB, and we will have to calculate effective memory access time. Formula, let's use the formula. When there is a hit, 80% of time, you require how much time? One TLB access time plus one main memory access time plus, when there is a miss, one TLB access time plus two times main memory access times. How much it is? 320 into 0.8 plus 620 into 0.2. Batao kitana aa raha hai? I will calculate by myself also. 320 into 0.8 plus 620 into 0.2. And I am getting 380 nanosecond. Is that fine? Are you getting the same answer, 380 nanosecond? Now, what I am going to do is, I am going to simplify this formula. Look at this. I am multiplying H inside. Let's do multiply H inside. H into TTLB. Okay, let me use the another color pen. H into T of TLB plus H into T of MM plus 1 minus H into TLB. So let's multiply 1 minus H also into TLB. So what you will get here is T of TLB minus H of TTLB. I have multiplied TTLB in one also, minus H also. Now I am dividing this two times separate. So one time TMM, I am multiplying here. So it becomes TMM minus HTMM plus another time I am not multiplying, or you can even multiply one another TMM minus HTMM. Is that fine? TMM plus TMM you can write, or two times TMM you can write, same to same, TMM into H, TMM into 1. I did it. Yes. Look at this. You can cancel out HT's TLB to HTTLB, HTMM to HTMM. That's it. Yes. Now I do have this. T of TLB plus T of TMM plus 1 minus H into TMM. How? Look at this. T of TLB, T of TMM, 1 minus H sub. Just take common TMM from here, 1 minus H into TMM. This is easy? Easier? Yes. How?
Look at this. Whether hit one time TLB and one time main memory access required, yes. Miss one time TLB and one time main memory access required, yes. But when there is a miss, one time TMM required extra. So when there is a hit, 80% time TLB plus TMM required, plus 20% time also TLB plus one time TMM required, yes. Means 100% time TLB and TMM required, yes. But one TMM required extra when there is a miss once again. So when there is a miss, one extra TMM required, remaining time, all the time, one TLB and one when main memory access required always. That's how you can remember. And in that particular case, if you will solve this particular question using that formula, it becomes even easier. How? One TLB access required always, plus one main memory access required always, plus only when there is a miss, one main memory access extra. 320 plus 300 ka 0.2, 6380 nanosecond. It is easy to solve even though without calculator. This will become little tough than this one. Is that understandable for everybody? Can you confirm? Okay, fine. Chal. Ab ye question aapko solve karna hai. You solve this question, I am waiting for your answer. I will wait for your answer for this question. Romit Soni asks, sir, formula kaise yaad rakhe? अगर आपको कंसेप्ट याद रहेगा तो फॉर्मूला याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी, ऑटोमेटिकली फॉर्मूला बन जाएगा आपसे. हां जी बिल्कुल, इट इज लाइव. टीएलबी में डेटा कौन रखता है? सी, व्हेनेवर यू एक्सेस सम डेटा, इफ टीएलबी हैज दैट पर्टिकुलर यू नो एंट्री ऑलवेज और ऑलरेडी, that's well and good. If not, then when there is a miss in TLB, the memory management unit, there is a memory management unit, that memory management unit brings the recent referenced entry from main memory's page table to TLB. So there is an automated process in CPUs, in the system's memory management unit. So when there is a memory management unit implemented, that memory management unit brings the more frequent or more recent referenced page table entry into where? In the TLB. So as soon as you will access few of the entries, those entries will come into the TLB automatically. Okay, are you solving this question or just I'm just waiting for nothing? आप ये क्वेश्चन सॉल्व कर रहे हो या नहीं? बताओ, टेल मी, आर यू गाइस सॉल्विंग दिस क्वेश्चन? ओके फाइन, आई डोंट थिंक सो. यू आर एबल टू प्रोसीड फर्दर विद दिस. Consider a system using TLB for paging with TLB access time is 40 nanosecond. So TLB given as 40 nanosecond. What hit ratio is reduced? Oh, not reduced, it should be used. What hit ratio is used for TLB to reduce the effective memory access time from 400 to 280 nanosecond? Means hit ratio is not given. We need to calculate it. The TLB should have or should be used with what hit rate so that the effective memory access time, previously we had 400 nanosecond, without TLB, now with TLB it can become 280 nanosecond.
Without TLB, it is 400. With TLB, you make 280 nanoseconds. So T effective is actually 280 nanoseconds. But T effective without TLB is 400 nanoseconds. अब थोड़ा सोच के बताओ, in the default cases when there is no any TLB used, what is the effective memory access time? थोड़ा पीछे जाना पड़ेगा, हमको याद नहीं रहता सर. When there is nothing given by default, what is the effective memory access time? ये देखो डब्बे में पैक करके रखा है हमने 2 of TMM. So this is equal to twice of main memory access time. Can you calculate main memory access time from here? Yes, it is 200 nanosecond, Babu. It is 200 nanosecond. So now you put the values in the formula. Effective memory access time is equal to 1 time TLB access plus 1 time main memory access plus when there is a miss, which I don't know how much, then another main memory access. Get the value of H from here. Get the value of H from here. Now I guess you can do that much at least. If you haven't till now learnt aptitude, then I would recommend that whichever subject finishes now, you take up aptitude next. You know why? Just because if you will not solve the aptitude, then you will not be able to solve such questions quickly. See, the game is who solves easy questions, known questions as soon as possible, so that unknown and complex questions may get extra time in the GATE exam. You will have only 3 hours, not 3 days to solve all 65 questions. Yes. So if you can solve such questions quickly within the flash, for that, what you need is a good grasp, a good grip on aptitude. Yes, these fractions, percentage, etc., etc., requires a good grip on the aptitude. If you have a good aptitude, you can solve such kind of questions quickly. And in that case, you can save a lot of time to solve the complex problems in the GATE exam, and which will make you plus 2, plus 4, plus 6 extra marks gainer in the GATE exam. I hope you are understanding my particular advice. For aptitude, you can go to our one of our team's channel, Apti Express by Saurabh Thakur sir. Okay, chalo. Fine, तो आज का ये हमारा सेशन खत्म होता है, but there are few informations very very important, so please listen those information. Tomorrow we are going to learn a very important topic, just because within last 4 years 2 questions have been asked from this TLB mapping and tags. What is the tag in TLB, how the mapping happens, why mapping required, etc., etc. Tomorrow we are going to discuss, and which is very very important. I'm telling you, last 4 years they have asked 2 times question same type in multiple exams are coming. The questions from this particular topic in multiple exams, the questions are coming from this particular topic. So please don't ignore this. This can be little tough initially, but the questions will be very easy to solve once you learn the concept, how to understand that concept. Plus, if you are preparing for placement or if in the future you will require placement preparation, then we have a new category for you on Unacademy's platform. As you create an account for GATE ESC category, similarly, you can create your account freely on Unacademy's platform in the placement preparation category. And for this placement preparation category, we are going to conduct a scholarship test freely on 11th of July, 7 p.m. Use the code VDeep10 to unlock this scholarship test and you can win up to 100% scholarship for your this placement preparation. Apart from that, there will be a daily winner who can win an iPad daily. Plus, you are having so many other opportunity to earn some kind of gift vouchers. If you want the PDF of the classes or announcement of our channel, then you can join this Telegram channel. One more announcement for all of you, and that announcement is tomorrow 3:30 p.m. I am going to go live so that I can have a big announcement for all of you. You are the self-preparation student for GATE. For you, I am going to bring a very, very big thing, which can change entire perspective of your preparation. I'm telling you, which can change entire perspective of your preparation. How that perspective goes, I will teach you, but I will reveal that particular thing tomorrow, 3:30 p.m. on this particular channel. If you want to take Unacademy Plus subscription, take it as soon as possible, just because price hike we extended so that you can still take the subscription with 10% discount, and with old prices, less prices only. You need to use the code VDeep10 so that you can take 10% discount plus my personal guidance separately. Look at this. These are the educators who are going to train you on Unacademy's platform, and these are the prices. Look at this. 12 months, 24 months and 18 months for GATE Plus subscription and 12 months, 24 months for Iconic subscription. There is a scholarship test for GATE ESC also. What you need to do for that is you need to enroll for Unacademy Combat. What Unacademy Combat can bring you? If your rank is 1 to 3, you will get 1 year subscription absolutely free. If your rank is 4 to 10, you will get 75% scholarship discount. 11 to 50, 50%, 51 to 100, 25% discount you can get. Use the VDeep10 code to unlock this particular combat absolutely free. This combat is gonna be a mega combat. Why? Just because apart from the scholarship, some lucky 500 participants will win the prizes, exciting prizes. There is a bug bounty. If you feel or if you find any inappropriate content on an Academy's platform, then just report to the team and they will give you the bounty prize. Thank you so much for joining. Please support the channel by liking and sharing the sessions with all of your friends. Subscribe the channel, turn on the notification and keep learning happily. Thank you so much. See you in the next class tomorrow. Till then.